great storm, see. We always say at home, it's marvelous to be a sailor and don't have to go to sea in this weather. In 1963, Glyndebourne decided to stage the opera Capriccio for the first time. I was invited to sing Countess Madeleine. And as a stage producer, there was Günther Rennert, with whom I had worked in Salzburg some years earlier. I knew him as a very sophisticated, intellectual, serious, and sharp person. And I always dreaded his arrogant but elegant remarks after rehearsal. So on the morning of the first rehearsal, I tried to make myself look as beautiful as possible and sophisticated, and that took some time. So I set out very late from my house in Friston to drive along the winding roads down to Glyndebourne at full speed, because I didn't want to be late. And then after one sharp bend, I had to brake, because I nearly ran into a herd of cows. There must have been about 50 of them being taken from one meadow to the other, and they completely blocked the road. So there I was in my car, you know, driving at the cow speed, so to say. And I arrived at Glyndebourne very late, very hot, very unelegant, very embarrassed, and approached my stage director. And I said, I'm terribly sorry, Dr. Rennert. I know I'm very late, but there were cows. I wish you could have seen his face. When I first arrived to Glyndebourne, I tell you the year, 1957, I took over from one of the most beloved artists who has ever sung here, and that was Senna Jurinats. And when I said farewell to Glyndebourne, my parts were taken by an artist who has made herself very dear to the Glyndebourne audiences. And it's a privilege and a joy for me tonight to present and leave the stage to Felicity Lott.